And you've got Agosto on Allen as well. So we'll see if the Blue Hens can use their height. They go down to Goss early. He works on Flowers, and they get started 20 seconds in. Scored 15 points against the Colonials. Cotton with a nice step back. And that's huge for Vershawn. Turned it over four times and played just 17 minutes. Goss with a little move, and he beats Flowers again over the top. Right. Dribbling from Anderson. And almost got too fancy with it. Wide open look, and it's down right away. Johnny McCoy.
They've done that in a lot of their wins this season, so they've got to be tested.
No look from Cotton to Clark. That's a pretty feed. And Clark's to the rebound, his second. Batts wasting no time. That's Julian Batts at his best. From the top of the screen, he's up to 5 points.
Yeah.
Clark needs to get back on defense. In the meantime, it's Allen, and he answers back for Delaware. Year-old record. Cotton feeling it tonight. Vershawn with his second triple, and he's up to 8 points. Yeah. He plays a lot bigger than he is. He goes to Batts, and Julian, just like Cotton, has it working from the outside. That's unbelievable from Jermaine Jackson. The roll to Clark, it was taken away. Darling bounces for Mutz. Mutz has that speed and lays it in for two.
Better go up with it.
Cutting in, it's Goss.
The basket like that.
Darling 0 for 6 from the floor, but he does have 4 assists. Clark with the angle, and he's got 8 points. At noon start on Sunday at the Barclays. Agosto flying to the rim. Shots. Mutz has been the Blue Hens' best offensive player, and he does it again. Started the season opener at URI with Raiquan Clark unavailable. And there's the big rejection. Yeah, it certainly was. Clark inside the arc. It's nothing but net for Raiquan. 7 straight points for the Blue Hens. Batts, why not? He gets the roll.
Over.
19 points in 18 minutes. That seems like a long time ago. Clark, beautiful. Agosto with the dish. Anderson. Valentine lost the rebound, and Mutz beats him one-on-one. Jackson always does. What a find. Ty Flower is easy.
Paint, and then just a nice little layoff when he garnered all that attention.
Third assist for Jackson, and an uncontested bucket for Darling. Here's the roller. Whoa, Mutz, are you kidding me? Sharks can take it down to 232. It's Flowers with a huge triple. Delaware does not have to rush. They get a three from Darling. Back within two. And now a three would give Delaware its first lead of the second half. Darling all the way. He ties it up at 64. Oh, Mutz batted around. Here come the Sharks. Flowers for the win. We are going to overtime. Wow. And remember, the leading scorers, Mutz and Clark, have 4 fouls. Look out, Nate Darling's on a roll. Exactly 13 months ago when they lost by 5 against Milwaukee. Batts with the right hand. Several double overtime games. Allen in the lane, it just stayed in. Been there a little bit more than LIU in recent memory. Jackson, look at this. Oh, baby, Jermaine!
And his job to block that.
Anderson skipped it. Darling, oh, he's got a triple. After Allen knocked over the side rail. Remember that slow start from Nate Darling? He's got 18. Julian, yes, tied at 71. Jackson hit that left corner three. He's got a step back. Yes, Jermaine Jackson with 5 in overtime. Junior's given LIU the lead. Anderson for the tie, you bet. Still time for the Sharks. Clark bodying. Clark bypassing. He has given LIU another lead.
Left.
Jackson taking over. Jackson running out of room. Bats with a cross court to Flowers. You can count it. What a pass from Julian Bats. That's a big win for the Sharks. A quick handshake for the coaches. And it took 45 minutes, but LIU prevails. They take down Delaware 82-75.